friends, Shelley here, the Youth and Family Program Coordinator, and I'm here today to share with you one of the activities we have as part of our Taking Faith Home toolkit we're using to learn, grow, and practice our faith together each and every day. The activity we have for today that we're going to go over is the devotions that are listed in the program. And so the devotion is a great opportunity to read one of our scripture verses. And then there's some information and questions for reflection, as well as a prayer. So for today, the devotion is around Mark chapter 9, verses 38 through 50. So we'll start by reading that as suggested in the devotion, and then we'll look at the rest of it together. This is, "Whoever is not against us is for us. Teacher," said John, "we saw a man driving out demons in your name, and we told him to stop because he was not one of us." "Do not stop him," Jesus said. "No one who does a miracle in my name can in the next moment say anything bad about me. For whoever is not against us is for us. I tell you the truth, anyone who gives you a cup of water in my name, because you belong to Christ, will certainly not lose his reward. And if anyone causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him to be thrown into the sea with a large millstone tied around his neck. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life maimed than with two hands to go into hell, where the fire never goes out. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life crippled than to have 2 feet and be thrown into hell. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than to have 2 eyes and be thrown into hell, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched. Everyone will be salted with fire. Salt is good, but if it loses its saltiness, how can you make it salty again? Have salt in yourselves and be at peace with each other." And the devotion in our program says, "What Jesus says in this reading is difficult to understand and seems very harsh. Jesus knows his life will not be easy and that following him will not be easy either. A caring conversation question once asked, when have you felt judged for your faith? One person's answer was from fellow Christians. The responder noted that it was also easy for him to look down on other Christians who are not like himself. We tend to want other believers to fall into our own patterns and ways of being a Christian. Jesus clearly rejects this attitude for his disciples. If others are doing good deeds in Jesus' name but are not a member of your congregation or denomination, leave them alone. Otherwise, we may be causing someone to unnecessarily trip and fall, and they can be seriously hurt in the process. In the strongest terms possible, Jesus cautions us not to be the cause of others to stumble and fall. That is not the way of a follower of Jesus. Jesus wants us to be at peace with one another." So, for a little discussion with somebody nearby, you can maybe reflect on this question. In what ways can you communicate a message of peace with others? So if you have someone nearby, go ahead and talk about it. And if not, maybe jot it down or talk to God about it. And I'll close us out of our devotional time with this prayer. God of steadfast love, help us to support the faith and efforts of Christians who do acts of love and mercy that may be different from our own, for the sake of Jesus Christ. Amen. I hope you have a great day, and I'll talk to you again really soon.